Rock and roll suffered an enormous hit a few years back when AC/DC turned down the volume and quietly faded into the background. But there was little choice. Co-founder Malcolm Young had lost his long battle with illness, and other members of the group were plagued by their own demons. For a band that had been so successful, not to mention so loud, for almost 50 years, the silence without AC/DC was deafening. Now, though, there's been an unexpected but incredible musical miracle, which proves it is possible to do U-turns on the highway to hell. It's the comeback that no one saw coming. The band that wrote the rock and roll rule book, back to give it another shot. AC/DC's two veteran frontmen itching to get out and raise the roof once more.
Angus has this crazy energy. Everybody knows that when he comes on, you know, it's this, when he puts the suit on, it is, you know, it's Clark Kent, Superman. There's just this energy and you cannot help but drink it all in.
This is shit!
Sometimes we go in and they're roaring before we get on. And I say, maybe we shouldn't get on because they're having such a great time at the moment. Don't want to get on and kill it for them.
No pressure.
No pressure, yeah.
All right.
I've got my cup of tea and I'm
Angus,
right there. I'm about to
see you now.
There I am.
Who are you?
There I am. You're going to go, who's that weirdo behind the lady?
They may be reunited, but right now, thanks to COVID, 65-year-old Angus Young and 73-year-old Brian Johnson are half a world away, brought together by technology.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome you to 60 Minutes Australia, which is already a day ahead of everybody else. So bollocks to a lot of you.
I'm getting an indication of how this is going to go. It's little wonder they're both in high spirits.
I am strong like bull. I fear no man.
This is why we love you.
Yeah.
Given the ordeal of the last few years, it's a miracle that AC/DC is together at all. I just want to say, thank you, Akadaka. You have saved 2020.
Yeah, good stuff. Yeah.
Oh, well, thank you very much, me darling.
Is it a good feeling to be making music again?
There was like electricity in the air, and it's hard to explain, you know, but everybody got back together, the familiar boys, the faces, and, you know, it was just a fun time, you know, it was brilliant.
It's a long way to the top if you want to rock and roll. It's a long way to the top if you want to rock and roll.
Ever since those early days with the late Bon Scott, AC/DC have known exactly who they are.
I'm on the highway to hell. On the highway to hell.
The hardest working band in rock, turning it up to 11 with a bone-shattering sound that has always been in a lane of its own. And the good news is that their 17th studio album, Power Up, is another almighty dose of precisely what fans know and love. I listened to the new music over the weekend and boom, like it hits you straight in the face. It's familiar, it's distinct. You know you're listening to Akadaka.
That's what we always strive for. You go, you want somebody to put it on, you know, and they hear it and they go, that's them. You know, you can get plenty of copiers, but there's no one like them when they kick off.
What has changed, of course, is the terrible loss of Malcolm Young, who died 3 years ago. Angus's older brother was the other founding member of AC/DC, whose effortless riffs on rhythm guitar set the standard for rock. While he may have been a master of blending into the background, he was always the backbone of the band.
It was his creation, his idea, yeah? His whole thing, yeah? When I was young and he said, me and you were going to play together, I said, you're kidding, you know? And he said, no, you've got the goods, you know? So from that moment, I was like, you sure now? You want me playing next to you on stage? And he went, yeah. You're as good as a guitarist as anyone else. So that's how he was. He settled on something and he said, and this is what we'll do. Mm. So it was all his idea, you know.
I also think you're underplaying your role in this partnership, this creative partnership between the two of you.
Yeah, but, you know, I was Mal. To Mal, I was still his younger brother, you know. But what was good with Mal was he'd make it practical, you know. You know, sometimes he would say, yeah, we got those cannons. Could we maybe shoot you out one? No, we're not.
Did you ever say no?
Yeah, I know I'm your kid brother, but we don't have to get that far.
Brian, how many times did you have to save Angus from Malcolm over the years?
If it had been feasible, he would have sent them out of a cannon if it had been said.
Right.
I mean, hey, listen, he sent me up on a wrecking ball. Swinging above an audience. That was scary as hell. He was the lad for ideas, yeah. Certainly.
AC/DC's story began back in 1973 with the Youngs, an extraordinary musical family. Immigrants from Scotland, they were the battlers of Burwood in Sydney's inner west.
I mean, there was seven boys altogether and my one sister, yeah? And all the boys could play, they could play guitars, saxophone, clarinet, accordions, pianos. Gonna have fun in the city.
Be with my girl, she's so pretty. Brother George was the first to find fame with the Easy Beats. Although it was Sister Margaret who first came up with the idea of that trademark school uniform.
You know, she's the one that said Angus should go on in his school suit, you know, because, you know, you always look so cute with the guitar. The guitar looked bigger than me.
And you still look cute in your uniform playing guitar, I've got to say.
Well, I'm a little bit wrinkled now.
But it was the 41-year partnership of brothers Angus and Malcolm that would change the sound of rock forever. Something Malcolm spoke about in a rare interview with 60 Minutes in 1996.
We weren't too proud on stage. It's, you know, there was a lot of other bands who probably musically had more going for them than us guys, but, you know...
So what was it that you guys had?
Well, we just had balls, I think. You know, we had the balls to get up there and make fools of ourselves, if that's what it took. But no, it's a life for us. It's our life. It's a circus life in a way, but it's a good life.
In 2014, everything changed when AC/DC announced that Malcolm would be taking a break due to ill health. It was the start of a brutal three-year battle with dementia that would claim his life.
I think the hardest part was not so much in passing, because that that was a kind of end, you know, the relief. I think the worst part's the decline. Yeah, that's the hard part. Because of how you knew him, and then to see that was gone, you know. But he was, I would say, even to the end, he was still, if I was there, he had from here to here, he had a big smile. And I think that was probably the, you know. Well, for me, that always gave me a kind of joy, even though he was in that state. That was always the joy of it. He still got a great kick if I played him guitar.
Did he?
Yeah. He would, you know, try to tap his foot, you know. But he always knew I was there. So that was a big thing. And I was with him at, you know, towards the end, so.
That's really that important time.
Yeah. So.
And for you too, Brian, you'd spent so many years with him. You were a brother of sorts too.
Yeah, it was very emotional when he went. It's all too soon, isn't it? It's too quick and too soon.
Coming up...
just buried me head in a whiskey bottle and pretended the world wasn't there.
From the bottom of a bottle... they always say that fixes things, but I'm not sure it does. ...to the top of the world.
We all got a strong bond. It's part of your blood.
The musical miracle that saved AC/DC.
I said yes twice.
Well, just in case you didn't hear you the first time.
Thanks for watching 60 Minutes Australia. To continue watching this story, click here for part two. You can stream all 60 Minutes episodes and clips exclusively on 9Now.